Hello everyone, welcome to this new video on rendering an already created RDLC report in an Angular application. Before we get into the process, let me give you a small introduction to RDLC reports. An RDLC report is an XML-based file that contains the report layout, parameters, and other report-related information. The main difference between RDLC and RDL reports is that RDLC reports are designed to pass the data report from applications. RDL reports, on the other hand, intend for the data to be retrieved by processing the report through a report viewer. We need to set 4 items to render an RDLC report in the report viewer. Reporting service. This service is used to interact with server-side report processing. Processing mode. This option specifies whether to process the report in local or remote mode. The reports will be processed as RDL if the processing mode is set as remote and RDLC if set as local. Report path. This option is used to set the path of the report that we are going to render in the Angular report viewer. Data sources. This is used to assign the required data to the report. First, I need to create a reporting service. To do that, I create an ASP.NET Core Web API application in Visual Studio 2022. And I install the boldreports.net.core NuGet package in the created application. Then I create a new controller file and name it reportviewercontroller.cs. In the controller file, I add the necessary using statement. In the route attribute, I add the action placeholder. And I remove the API controller attribute. Inherit the iReportController. I copy the necessary variables and methods from the documentation. And paste them inside the report viewer controller class. Then I open the program.cs file. And add the add memory cache. And add cores methods. After that, I add the useCores method. Create a folder named www.root in the root folder. Inside the www.root folder, I create a folder named resources. And inside that, I add the already created productlist.rdlc report. For this demo, I have an ASP.NET Core reporting service. You can also use an ASP.NET report service. I have provided the documentation links for both, as well as a link to the sample report in the video description for your convenience. Next, I need to create an Angular application. Before that, make sure your development environment includes Node.js version 8 or higher, and NPM version 3 or higher. Install the Angular CLI globally in the system by running npm install in the command prompt. The Angular CLI is a command line interface tool that allows you to initialize, develop, scaffold, and maintain Angular applications directly from a command shell. Create a new Angular application by running the ng new command. Here I named my Angular application Angular RDLC Report Viewer. The ng new command prompts you for information about features to include in the initial app project. Accept the defaults by pressing Enter. Next, let's configure the Report Viewer control in the Angular application. To change the directory to the Angular application root folder, run the change directory command in the command prompt. Install the Bold Reports Angular library in the Angular application using the npm install command. The library should be installed as a dev dependency. Install the @boldreports/types library in the Angular application. Open the Angular application root folder in Visual Studio Code. I am using Visual Studio Code in this demo for editing purposes. Open the tsconfig.app.json file. and added bold reports slash types and it types under the typeroots array. And add jQuery and reports.all under the types array. Then, I open the polyfills.js file inside the src folder. And I import the window.jQuery object, which is required to render the report viewer control. Here, window refers to the global object on the client side. Next, let me add the CSS reference to the Angular application. Open the angular.json file. Register bold.reports.all.min.css under the styles array. Bold.reports.all.min.css includes the CSS properties for the reporting component. Angular 10 and newer will throw a common JS or AMD dependencies can cause optimization bailouts warning due to adding the scripts in the app.module.ts file because they use the AMD module loader. To remove the warning, add the report viewer, bullet graph, and chart scripts within the allowed common JS dependency section. The allowed common JS dependency should be added under the options section. And the options section will be available under the Angular application name section. Now let me add the report viewer component. Open the app.module.ts file. Import the addBoldReports/AngularReportingComponents library. addBoldReports/AngularReportingComponents provides the UI component for the Angular Report Viewer control. I copy the necessary scripts from the documentation and add them in the app.module.ts file. I add the Bold Report Viewer module in the imports array. I save the file. Next, I want to add the script files. First, I open the index.html file from the src folder. Second, I copy the scripts from the documentation and add them in the head tag. Third, I need to configure the report viewer template in the Angular application. So, I open the app.component.html file and replace it with this code. In this code, ID is a string that specifies the unique name for the report viewer control. Report service URL is the service URL of the report service. Report path is used to set the path of the report. Style indicates the width and height for the report viewer control. The view report click event allows you handle the view report button click on the client side. I save the file. Now let's configure the report viewer component in the Angular application. Open the app.component.ts file. Declare the necessary variables and constructor inside the app component class. Inside the constructor, I assign the value for the report service URL and report path. Then I copy view report click from the documentation, which passes the report parameter value, and paste it inside the app component class. I save the file. Next, I open the reporting service application. First, I create a class file named productlist.cs in the application root folder. I copy the code from the documentation and paste it inside the productlist class. Then I open the report viewer controller.cs file from the controllers folder. In the onInit report options method, first I set the value for processing mode to local. Next, I need to load the report as a stream. To do that, first I create a variable named basePath and assign the folder path value which has the report. Then I combine the basePath along with the report path which is sent from the HTML application. Next, I create an instance for the file stream and assign the file path to it. Then I create the memory stream and copy the file stream value to it. Then I assign the report stream value to the report option.reportModel.stream variable. Then I add the data value collection to the data source value. Here, name is case sensitive, and it should be the same as the data source name in the report definition. The value accepts iList, dataset, and data table inputs. I save the file. And now everything is ready to render the RDLC report from the report service. First, I build and run the service. And then I run the ng-serve open command in the command prompt. You can see the browser open to URL http://localhost4200, and the report is loaded in the browser. Let me summarize what we covered. We saw how to create an Angular application, and how to reference the required scripts to render the RDLC report, and how to set the variables that need to be declared to render the RDLC report. I have provided a documentation link in the description below for the steps that are followed in this video. I have also provided a link to our article, Enabling Image Rendering with Report Viewer on Linux and Other Non-Windows Platforms After .NET 6 for your reference. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.